Good morning and welcome to Mornings on Main Street for this Thursday, the 21st of September. I'm your host, Stefanie Miller. Thanks so much for joining us. I hope your day is off to a nice start. Here's what we have coming up for you today. We are talking all things Apple with Devon O'Day and Sylvia Ganier from Green Door Gourmet in today's portion of Devon's Table. Again, all things apples, because this time of year, I mean, who doesn't love getting in the kitchen to bake a hot apple pie, an apple crumble or crisp? Maybe making some homemade apple cider or apple butter. I'm making myself hungry, so I should stop. But you have to watch some of this segment if you would like to see more of Devon's Table. And Devon O'Day, you can find that by going to Main Street Media TV Mobile. Not only that, of course, you can find all of our shows from Mornings on Main Street, as well as a number of sports shows. Just a terrific spot to go to get information. Also today, I get to share with you all things Best of Clarksville. Best of Clarksville is coming up on October 5th. There's still a number of volunteer opportunities. This is one way to not only show your favorite business or professional in the Clarksville-Montgomery County area some love, but all proceeds go back to local nonprofits in the Montgomery County area. Also, over the next week and a half, I'll be sharing with you some of those nonprofit stories and what this money, what these proceeds mean to their nonprofit organizations. And then we end out today by hearing from reporter Scott Stewart out of Pulaski. He recently sat down with District 70 State Representative Clay Doggett to talk about what came out of the recent special session. And today they're highlighting school safety and mental health. It's a wonderful sit-down conversation between Scott and Clay, and they want to make sure that you hear all of the important information. But first, let's get a check of our headlines and what you can find at MainStreetMediaTN.com. For the third consecutive year, United Community is encouraging its employees to either initiate acts of service in their communities or join projects led by the Together for Good Council. The United Community Bank Foundation will also contribute a total of $25,000 to local organizations that provide support to first responders. This is all in observance of the 9/11 National Day of Service and Remembrance. Read more of United Community's efforts to raise money by heading to MainStreetMediaTN.com. University of Tennessee Forensic Anthropology Department, Texas-based Forensic Genealogy Laboratory, Othram, Inc., and a one-time grant from the Tennessee General Assembly are making it possible for unknown victims to be identified. Four of 10 cases so far submitted have seen a significant update thanks to that one-time grant of $100,000 in 2022 called the Unidentified Human Remains Initiative. For specialized forensic genealogy testing for TBI cold cases with unidentified skeletal remains, you can learn so much more about this and how you can still help by going to our website. Tennessee now has its 18th trauma center. It is the Vanderbilt Wilson County Hospital. The entirety of VWCH has access to capabilities, including interventional radiology, which is used as a treatment for cancer and other conditions without major surgery, urology coverage, round-the-clock anesthesia coverage, and expanded availability of life-saving blood products. Learn what it takes to be a trauma center by going to MainStreetMediaTN.com and clicking on Chronicle of Mount Juliet. We have so many great stories that you can find at MainStreetMediaTN.com. Now this morning, hopefully some good information when it comes to the weather and what it's going to feel like the next couple of days. Let's check in with Tennessee Valley Weather for our forecast.
From the Tennessee Valley Weather Center, this is your weather today.
Good Thursday morning to you. I'm Kelly Rawson here in the Tennessee Valley Weather Center with a check at your forecast. We do have clouds hanging around this morning with maybe a few peaks of sunshine and maybe a few showers around this morning as well. You can see very spotty in nature across southern middle Tennessee, but the chance is there. We'll call it about a 20% chance for this afternoon. Definitely not everybody going to see a rain shower, and we're not talking thunderstorms either, just some light to moderate rainfall Potentially, but most of us again do stay dry, clearing out and drying out for your Thursday evening. Temperatures falling into the 70s and 60s overnight, bottoming out in the upper 50s to lower 60s with a mostly clear sky for your Friday morning. And then we will increase into the 80s once again by Friday afternoon, but we will stay dry for Friday and Saturday. Sunday, though, however, that is when we start a little bit of a more unsettled weather pattern here in the Tennessee Valley, with a 20% chance of showers and storms Sunday through midweek.
Well, apples are the flavor of fall, and this morning we are starting off in the kitchen with Devon O'Day and Sylvia Ganier, owner of Green Door Gourmet. They are talking all things apple and sharing just the number of varieties of apples. I can't wait to be in the kitchen as they do this, so let's sit back and listen.
At Devon's table, I'm here with Sylvia Ganier, and we are at Green Door Gourmet. Green Door Gourmet has a bunch of recipes, and there are some recipes for apples, I'm just going to say, and I've already known they're for sweet and savory and all sorts of stuff in between. But I'm confused about apples.
Don't be confused. Let me help you.
You going to help me? Okay, tell me.
All right, so there are a number of different varieties of apples that are traditional southern apple varieties. And we've got some of the most well-known ones from having our traditional Granny Smith, which is the best cooking apple. It's a firm apple. It doesn't lose its shape when you're cooking. Hold as a slice. It's not quite as sweet, so you can put some sugar with it. You didn't become overly sweet for that, so your Granny Smith.
And they're not as much, I don't love a Granny Smith to just pick up and bite into, because they're a little sour. There's your sour apple, but they're perfect for baking. I love it.
And then we're moving on down. We have the traditional eating apple, a Gala.
They're my favorite. I love a Gala.
And, you know, the kids always gravitate toward a red apple. It's just great. If you can give a kid a healthy snack, I'm all for it. So we love these. When you see the apples that still have the leaves attached, then you know that it is local and it is a good fresh apple.
So you have local apples.
Yes, all these are local. We're just gonna love these. It's local.
Who knew? Okay, the Gala apples too are really great dipped in peanut butter. That's another that has your protein in it for your kids that want a snack and they don't like a lot of things. They like PBJ. This is a nice alternative to the PBJ.
Absolutely, this ain't that bread. All of these apples also go deliciously along with sparkling wine and a little bit of brie. And so with Amber Falls, they do a nice sparkling and it's delicious with cheese and apple and brie. It goes so nice with that. It has a little green apple essence to it.
For the adults, not for the kids.
No,
I'm just kidding.
That's and the sticky puffs for the kids. All right, then we have Rome Beauty. This is another really good eating apple, but because it's kind of variegated and how it looks, some people are a little afraid of it. They're like, will it not ripen all the way? No, it's supposed to have the molting or the stripe to it. And then we have Mutsu.
I've never heard of a Mutsu apple.
So Mutsu was a hybrid between a Golden Delicious and a Granny Smith. It was first started in Japan, and it is a fantastic apple. If you cannot find a Granny Smith, and you want one that's a little bit nicer texture for eating, that still has some tartness to it, Mutsu is the way to go.
Fantastic.
We both like oats, right?
Yeah.
So you'll remember it. It's a Mutsu.
I love Mutsu apple.
Yes. Old-fashioned variety, the wine sap. This is the best applesauce apple, in my opinion. They're a good cooking apple, but they do kind of fall apart a little bit more than, say, the Granny Smith would. It has a delicious flavor. Wine sap is your applesauce or your dried apple for making a stack cake or something.
Yeah.
You can use your dried apple for that.
And then you use an air fryer to dry apples or a dehydrator?
You can use a dehydrator. You can use just about anything. Growing up, old screen door up on cinder blocks with another screen door on top of it. Lay out all your apples when it wasn't going to rain. Dry your apples.
I love it. I always say, you can get it for free right now on Facebook Marketplace. I'm just saying, if people are getting rid of old screen doors, you can clean it off real good. And then
no dust, but other than
That's it. Who knew? A do-it-yourself dehydrator. I love it.
If you have a gas oven, Mm-hmm. Your pilot light in your oven will keep your oven at about 110. Mm-hmm. If you put these on a sheet pan and don't have any liquid at all in there, leave them overnight, maybe overnight into the next morning. A lot of times you'll come out with a pretty good dried apple just from leaving it in the overnight gas oven without turning it on, just at the pilot light.
I love it.
I know I drink peppers that way a lot.
See, that's so important, to be able to make food last a little bit longer, because it won't always be apple season in Tennessee.
No.
So, but saving them as a dried apple, it's a great snack. You can cook with it. Oh, I love it. What about these?
And then this is the John Gold, which is also another, it's a good cooking apple. Mm-hmm. Again, not as firm as the Mutsu, which is not as firm as the Granny Smith. But a lot of people like to use this as a cooking apple. It's my favorite salad apple. Because it's sweet and it's crunchy and it holds up really nice to that. So I don't have to have a super sweet dressing for that particular thing, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
Again, if you would like to see more of Devon's Table, of course, Main Street Today, mornings on Main Street, or our sports programs, you can do that by going to our mobile app, downloading that on your mobile device. Just find Main Street Media TV Mobile in your app store. Stick right here on Mornings on Main Street. We have more coming up after this.
A tribute to Ronnie Millsap.
Smoky Mountain.
The final Nashville show, October 3rd at Bridgestone Arena. Featuring performances by Kelly Clarkson, Little Big Town, Parker McCollum, Scotty McCreary, Justin Moore, Tracy Lawrence, Trace Adkins, Stephen Curtis Chapman, and many more. Tickets on sale now at Ticketmaster. A tribute to Ronnie Millsap. The final Nashville show. One night only. October 3rd, Bridgestone Arena.
Y'all, I'm serious right now. They have a dragon here. I saw it.
Get out of here.
Come on, I'll show you. Wait up.
Whoa!
I told you so. That is a dragon.
At Old Hickory Credit Union, we're member-owned, not-for-profit, and eager to serve our Robertson County community. Since 1934, we have strived to provide our members with a safe, reliable place to take care of all their financial needs. From checking accounts, to loans, to mortgages, we're here to help. Credit unions have to constantly adapt to meet the needs of an ever-changing market. However, one constant will always remain, and that is the service we provide to our members. Stop by our Greenbrier branch today.
What separates us from other companies in Tennessee, that's going to be our mission to our customers, is to always improve the quality of life. That's from taking care of your pets to a friendly voice on the phone when you call, to a technician that comes out and he's competent, he's going to solve the problem for you. We're considered a full encompassing service, so we're going to take care of 50 plus different pests, and we'll always have your back.
Football season is grilling season. The Big Green Egg is the perfect grill for everyone, from the backyard cook to the world's most acclaimed chefs. Stop at Tennessee Ace Hardware today and check out our large selection of Big Green Egg grills. It's the perfect grill for any grilling need.
Welcome back to Mornings on Main Street. You know what time it is? It is almost time for the 27th annual Best of Clarksville here in, of course, Clarksville, right outside of the mall in the Clarksville area. If you haven't been, you need to come out for this event to tell us all about it. We have event organizer Melanie Thompson with us. You've been working with a board of people. You said that you have this down to a science now. When does this planning start?
We actually start in February of each year because over the last 3 years, and we partnered with Bikers Who Care, Clarksville Kiwanis, and Clarksville Rotary. It just takes a lot of volunteers to get this together, and it's such a great relationship that we all have, and have really made a lot of updates and changes to hopefully make it just a fun experience for everyone.
So let's talk about the updates and the changes. What's new this year?
What's new this year is you can actually purchase your tickets online. So that's nice. The first time. And then, but you can also, if you don't want to do that, you can purchase them at three different locations, Leatherwood Distillery, Plato's Closet, and Natalie's Dance Studio. And remember, they're $10 now, but they will be $15 at the gate at 5 p.m. on October 5th.
So, and here's the cool part to me. So you pay the money for your ticket beforehand or at the gate, either or, but do know your money goes to great causes here in the Clarksville, Montgomery County area. It's not only about showing the businesses that you love some love, but again, yes, helping out nonprofits who really need it. Who will be benefiting this year?
Well, the four charities we have this year, besides Clarksville Kiwanis, Clarksville Rotary, and Bikers Who Care, are Faith Cancer Care Foundation. We also have Michaela's Mutt Hotel. Mm-hmm. And then we have the Caleb Cares Project. And then we have ArtLink. So a good variety of nonprofits. And all the money stays here in Clarksville. Mm-hmm. And it goes 100% to the charities involved.
That's incredible. How much money was raised last year? Just to give you guys an idea of how much money is raised from this event.
I believe last year we raised about $130,000 gross.
And then being able to share that with these nonprofits, again, just making such a difference in the lives and the work that these nonprofits do. Looking at the night of the event, is there anything people need to keep in mind when they come out?
Just remember, you have to turn in your tickets or show your tickets to get a voting code so that you can vote.
Okay.
Have your ID, because we do have some vendors that are serving tastes of alcohol and beer and things that they make. And just come out and have a good time and be prepared to just support the community. And that's really what this event is.
And with all the businesses on hand, you are walking away with quite a bit of swag when you come out, because they all have
absolutely
something to hand to you at each of their tables. It
yes
seems.
Absolutely. We have people coming through with rolling suitcases and everything. it's an amazing, fun event, and you get a lot of exposure. Mm-hmm. So
they do. And will the winners be announced that evening?
Yes, winners are announced that evening. Voting stops at 7.
Okay.
And then probably within 15-20 minutes, we have all the votes tallied. Mm-hmm. And then we'll start handing out plaques.
Last question for you. Mm-hmm. You still need volunteers to set up on
yes
the 4th and the 5th?
Yes.
Where do we go?
You can go to thebestofclarksville.net. You can also contact me. My email is mthompson, T-H-O-M-P-S-O-N, at gobbb.org, and I'll be happy to help you.
Melanie, thank you so much for sharing all of this. Again, Best of Clarksville happening on October 5th here outside of the mall and the parking area. Believe me, you can't miss it when you come
no
out. Just find parking where you can.
Yes.
Stick with us here on Mornings on Main Street. We yes have more coming up after this.
Tired of hanging lights every year? We get it. That's why Southern Nights is here to help. We install programmable lighting on your home or business so you can enjoy beautiful, customizable lighting all year round. No more ladders, tangled lights, or cold nights outside. We do the work, you do the celebrating. Call Southern Nights today and take the hassle out of holiday lighting forever. For a free quote, give us a call at 931-241-3074 or visit our Facebook page at Southern Nights.
Dairy Berry's Heat and Air has been proudly serving the Middle Tennessee area for over 35 years. We have been voted Sumner County's best heat and air company for the past 8 years. For outstanding service, call Dairy Berry's at 615-452-8121.
When it comes to insurance, you want a name you can trust. Wendy Danielle Stack is here to help. With over 7 years of experience, Danielle and her team are here to assist you in finding the right coverage for all of your needs. From auto and home to life and business insurance, we have customized options for everyone. We'll work with you to create a personalized plan that protects everything in your life that matters most. Call today and see for yourself why Danielle Stack is the go-to insurance agent in Clarksville.
I'm Dr. Webb. I'm the owner and operator of Webb Aesthetic Plastic Surgery here in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. We offer services for both men and women, breast, body, and face for both.
I meet with patients who are ready to schedule surgery. We talk about their pre-op appointments, what to expect before surgery, what to expect during and after surgery.
We graduated medical school and nursing school the same day, and I had things that I believed in and stood by that I wasn't willing to compromise on. So when he came home, we had to discuss that we were on the same page with how we treated patients and staff. We want them to feel like they're part of our family.
Welcome back to Mornings on Main Street. This morning, we have a second part to the sit-down that reporter Scott Stewart had with District 70 State Representative Clay Doggett. They talked this morning about school safety and mental health. Here's more from their conversation.
We're here with Clay Doggett, and Clay, we're right on the heels of the special session, and there's the second part of this that I think we need to take into account. As far as the reason for this special session had to do with the Covenant shooting, because you stood right up there in the county commission not too long ago and told all that had gone on with the regular session. And I wanted to get you to go ahead and talk about some of that, that y'all have done some great stuff safety-wise.
Right. We put $232 million in the budget this last year to help with safety of our schools. That included having an SRO in every school in this state. Public school. If you are like Giles County, we already had SROs. We still got that money to use. So we could have either used that money to put an additional SRO in the schools. We could use that money to make sure, obviously, that we had the SROs in the school, but you could pull some of those that had been in the schools before, maybe serving in a couple different capacities as an SRO and a patrolman, and put more people on the road. So it was a great idea to do that for the state to step in and to fund that going forward. So we did that, and there were also safety measures that we passed to where schools could upgrade their security systems. They could do a lot of what we call hardening of their perimeters and their school buildings, making sure they get the things that they stand that they need. And also,
I think we've seen that too with the bullet, some of the bulletproof glasses or some coverings on the glass that makes them bulletproof. The ability to not see into the school, which I think is an amazing, makes a really, really hardens you a whole lot more than a lot of people realize. The staggered entryways. I mean, there's just a lot of things that you guys have made possible. And we can see it right here in Giles County. Mm-hmm. You just go to one of the schools close to you. And when you drive up, you can't see inside that school because of the coverings, and now those coverings are bulletproof.
Sure, right. Absolutely. I was going to touch on that. That film, protective film that they can put on the glass, there was one piece of legislation in the special session that will, I believe it's going to be brought back up whenever we come into a regular session, but it's an alarm system that goes on, kind of like a fire alarm. If you have a violent occurrence that happens at a school, that you're able to
lock down.
It's a lockdown. It's an alarm that goes off like the fire alarm. It automatically alerts law enforcement, EMS, fire department. All your first responders are made aware of it. It would alert central office so that they're aware. If you've got the camera systems, the cameras automatically pop up so that people can see. I mean, it's some really good technology, but that's something that we were really kind of pushing through to see done. We've had, there was a lot of really good discussions about mental health. A lot of things that we had discovered over the last couple years that have been brought to our attention. Used to, the state had state-run hospitals for people that were having, that were found in need of some mental health attention. And so in the last 15 years, I guess it was, they started slowly closing a lot of those hospitals, moving those facilities, scaling them down, scaling them back. We only have a few places right now. So if someone was having a mental health crisis or was in need of some mental health attention that required hospitalization, they would have to either go to Nashville or Knoxville or out west, western part of the state right now, but they don't have enough beds there to be able to see these folks and help get the treatment that they need. And so a lot of times from reports that we're hearing from law enforcement and other healthcare providers is that these people are just not getting what...
Maybe falling through the cracks. Almost.
They're falling through the cracks. A lot of this falls through the cracks. And also our mental health providers that we have in our communities are really spread thin. And there's not really been incentive for folks to go into that profession because it's kind of one of those things where you have from my understanding, where, you know, there's just not much that could have been done in a lot of places, just based off of the number of beds that have been that are down, the facilities that could help assist, providers in communities. And so we looked at several different things that dealt with mental health. One of those was raising the reimbursement rates so that we can go ahead and open up more beds. So
yeah.
Peninsula over around the East Tennessee area, around Knoxville area, they'll be able to open up like 500 beds from
what I was told
just, you know, by this appropriation that we did on mental health.
Welcome to the Omni Nashville Hotel, urban elegance with a vintage touch. Our 800-room hotel opened up in the fall of 2013 with 746 guest rooms and 54 suites.
Thomas Drugs, serving our community since the early 1900s. We're a full-service drugstore and soda fountain located in a building on Main Street that is on the National Register of Historic Places. We have a staff of pharmacists with over 70 years of experience, and we are committed to offering the best care and service to our community. We're now offering healthcare testing and treatment with positive results, a one-stop shop. Stop by our pharmacy today or visit our website at thomasdrugs.net.
He shoots, and he scores!
Here at Rock and Roll Sushi, we're proud to be the original American-style sushi restaurant founded on great food and rock and roll music, boasting concepts and flavors that are big, bold, and loud. We're the only place to experience the rock you love and the rolls you love with the ones you love. Come see for yourself why we're the best sushi experience in town. Find us at 108 Morris Road in Clarksville or visit our website at rockandrollsushi.com.
Welcome back. So glad you were here this morning. Get this. The first day of fall is Saturday already. Yep, September 23rd, the first day of fall. So all things fall, I love it. It's my favorite time of year, my favorite season. What about you? Again, I love it because of the sweaters and the boots and, of course, the pumpkins. Everything is already out. And thinking of fall, of course, your Halloween and just fall activities. If you're looking to pick some pumpkins and you would like to head out to one of Middle Tennessee farms, here's a couple for you this morning. We've already talked about Lucky Lad Farms in Eagleville. That is one spot for you to go. Another place, Honeysuckle Hill Farm. That's located in Springfield. You have Gentry Farm in Franklin. And then one last stop, the Lyon Family Farm in Fayetteville. So a number of places. That's just in Middle Tennessee. You have other locations if you're looking to travel to maybe East or West Tennessee. But there is just so many spots to visit and just walk around and enjoy some pumpkin picking, maybe a little corn maze, and a number of other fall festivities. Thanks so much for joining us here this morning. Have a fantastic afternoon, and we'll see you back here tomorrow morning.